I caddied in the 1960s when I was 12. I caddied at a golf course, and everybody was talking about the stock market then. It was the stock market had gone up for a long, long time, and if you were to get a haircut or anything, you would always be talking about stocks. And so I took my caddying money. I earned $6 a bag, and so I get $12 a round, and I took my caddying money, and I put it in the stock market. I was curious, and the first stock I bought was a company by the name of Northeast Airlines, and the only reason I bought it is because it was selling for less than $5 a share, and I figured I could buy more shares, so I'd make more money if it went up. That was my brilliant theory. Of course, it was dumb, but it was a company that was about to go bankrupt. Somebody acquired it. It tripled, and I was hooked. So I got hooked on the markets at that time.
I was trading in the debt of Northeast Airlines at that time. And
really? Really? But, how cool.
And we were debating shorting the stock versus our long position. The debt was selling at a substantial discount. And I think the time that Ray's talking about, if you ever want to check an archive, there was a book published, Happiness is a Stock That Doubles in a Year. And this was a period of time where if you couldn't make 50 or 100% of your money, you really weren't doing a good job. And it looked at the American Stock Exchange and all the stocks that doubled during this period of time in a year. And it basically concluded you should be focused on very low-priced stocks. So that book symbolized that issue.